Hi everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to explain how to use standard camera and standard light into a viewer interior scene. I've already explained how to create a standard camera in a previous tutorial. By using standard camera, you don't need to make too many adjustments to get optimal result. It's really practical, especially if you're a beginner in using V-Ray. First, we're going to change the environment. Pick rendering. And then choose environment. Click use map. And then click bitmap. Choose the environment you want to use. Open material editor or M. Drag the environment to one of the empty slots. Click instance and then OK. Now close. Now click Alt plus B. Click use environment background. Display background and then click OK. Now we can see the background on our viewport. Since the window is the only area in which we can see the background, we're going to adjust the background so it can fit to the window. We're going to use tiling to make the background smaller. Change to 1.5. Right here in the offset so we can move the background. When you finish, back to Alt plus B and then uncheck so it won't interfere with our drawing. Next, we'll go to Light, the third one from the left. Go to V-Ray, choose V-Ray Light, and then we put the light in front of the window. Now we change the setting, go to modifier, change multiplier value to 5, click invincible, uncheck effect reflection, change subdivision to 15 so you will get better shade, especially for the darker part of the room inside. Leave the rest as it is. Next, we go to rendering setup. You can also press F10. Choose the output size that you want. Don't forget to press Shift plus F. If you want to have different size, you can go to Custom, then change the value. You can also change the aspect, then you adjust the size. I like to use 1200 pixels because I think it's good enough when you print it in half page of A4 paper. Next, I go to Assign Renderer and then click. Choose V-Ray. Now go to Global Switches. If you want to increase your rendering speed, you can uncheck Displacement, unless you are using V-Ray Displacement in your model. Turn off the default light and then put 2 for maximum depth value. Change Adaptive Subdivision to Adaptive DMC. This time I'm going to use Mission Meta Valley for Anti-Aliasing Filter. I'll turn on the environment. Then change the color mapping. Turn off Effect Background and turn on Fan Optics. Then go to Indirect Illumination. Turn on indirect illumination, of course. Change the secondary bounce value to 0.8. I'm going to turn on the ambient occlusion. and then change the radius to 5. To get a softer result, I'm going to change the subdivision value to 15. I'm going to use light catch for secondary bounces. Next, I'm going to irradiance map, change the setting to very low, and show the calculation phase, and leave the rest as it is. Go to light catch, change the value to 600. Light catch in VHT is quite strong, so the value doesn't have to be so big. I leave noise threshold as it is. Then I change the maximum depth to 85. Change triangulation rendering from top to bottom rendering. I'm going to change my dynamic memory limit to 2000 so it will render faster. But you can adjust it to your own computer or leave it at 500. Change default geometry to static. Now try rendering it. If you're using Mac 2011 or 2010, you have to be careful that your light isn't overbright. Because if it's too overbright, it will slow the rendering process, or even in some cases, it will just collapse altogether. Next, we're going to make downlight. Go to create and then light. It's just the third button from the left. Go to photometric and then choose free light. I've already made three light points here. I'm going to make the first light. Move it to the light fixture. Go to modifier and then change the shadow to very shadow. Change the color to a warmer tone, like beige. But it should be really light. Okay. Next, change the shape to point. Light distribution type. Go to photometric web. And then find the IS file that you have. Click here. And then go to V-Ray shadow parameter. And then turn on area shadow. This will make the transition between light and dark a bit smoother, but it's also slowing down the rendering process. And then go to intensity, change the power to 8000. Place it right in the middle. Next, copy it to the other light points. Now we render. Now we're going to make the sunlight effect using direct light. First go to standard light and then target direct. Go to top view. Drag from here to the wall here. Change the shadow to V-Ray shadow. Change the intensity to 2. Drag the direction parameter to be bigger than the room. And then drag it again the other way. The difference between hotspot and falloff shouldn't be too small, because it will make the light too sharp and it won't be realistic. Go to V-Ray shadow parameter and then click area of shadow. Move the light a bit. Okay, that's good enough. Now we render it again. Next I'm going to make the front area to be blurrier than the focus, which is the headband using depth of field effect. First I'm going to turn on all the layers. And then in the sitting area here, I'm going to put a 3-seater sofa and an armchair. More or less like this. Now we go to camera. And then we go to environmental range. Show, change the mirror to about 50. The focus would be the camera focus. Now we go to rendering setup. Go to camera. Turn on depth of field. Change the aperture size just a little bit. The value shouldn't be too big because it really affects the blurriness. And then we get the focal distance from the camera as we set earlier, so we don't have to change the value here. Next we render it. But before that, I'm going to add one more light to the other window. I only put in this window, copy it using instance. Now we render it. Looks good, right? But remember, using depth of field slowing down the rendering process significantly. So I actually prefer not to use it and edit the rendering result using Photoshop instead. That's it for now. Have a nice day.